Today I am going to take about topic electricity in the subject physics for 10th standard. So it is very interesting subject because electricity is a common purpose we are using for everything also at home, such as for lighting the lamps, running the washing machine, fridge, everything also. Now, what is exactly electricity? Electricity is nothing but that electric current which has got that lot of energy to do all the works, giving the light, giving the heat, running that washing machine, everything also it has got that capability. Now, exactly what is electric current, what is happening there? So there are two charged particles are there. One is positive charged particles, we call it as protons. Negatively charged particles, we call it as electrons. So because both are having opposite charges, there will be force of attractions will be there. So it starts to flow and starts to flow in that circuit also, and it has got the capability of doing all kind of work also, whichever we can do, because it is a very useful purpose. Now let us see what exactly one charge. One charge is nothing but also we call it as 1 coulomb. That 1 coulomb is nothing but 6 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons. So 6 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons are moving, then we call this as 1 charge or 1 coulomb. Now we have to calculate how much charge 1 electron has got. So what you have to do? So for calculating 1 electron, its charge is nothing but, so when it goes to other side, we have to divide 1 divided by 6 into 10 to the power of 18. So what you will get the answer as 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 18 coulombs. Now we come to know that for 1 coulomb or 1 charge, how much electrons are needed. So 1 electron has got how many charges also. So based on this, we can also say that the current unit we call it as 1 ampere. So 1 ampere is nothing but the coulomb of charges, 1 coulomb of charges, that is Q is nothing but 1 coulomb of charges flowing per 1 second. Now, so this we can write as formula as Q divided by T. Sometimes the charge may change also, we are not exactly using as 1 coulomb also. According to bulb, okay, it may consume different power charges also. Fan may consume different charges, the time also will vary according to the appliance also. The formula we can write it as Q divided by T. So 1 ampere can be divided as when 1 coulomb of charges are flowing in 1 second, we call it as 1 ampere. Now I am going to explain about electric circuit. So what is meant by simple electrical circuit? Simple electrical circuit is nothing but one appliance it should have. One appliance. For working that one appliance, what we need mainly, there should be some switch should be there, correct, no? So switch or sometime we'll also have either power supply also, or we may connect batteries also, isn't it? For running any appliances, what we need exactly? One switch should be there, then battery or any power supply should be there, then one appliance. That is we call it a simple electrical circuit. Now I am going to draw and show you. So let us see here. So this is switch here. So switch we write, these are the electric circuit symbols actually. So what I have drawn is, so I should know about all these details also. Batteries normally we draw with a symbolic type and all. So like this you have to represent. Now appliances, let us say, now I am connecting the appliance such as bulb. Bulb also, there is a electrical symbols are there. So that same symbol, electrical symbols only we should use for drawing the electrical circuit, not like a exact like a bulb structures and all, not needed. So switch we write it as S, and battery here, because why I am saying battery means when 2-3 batteries are cells are connected, then we call this as battery also. Here bulb I am writing it as L. So this is we call it as simple electrical circuit. Now I am going to show you one of the small example how to solve the problems also. Now let us assume current 0.5 ampere current is flowing in the conductor. Now it has got the let us say it is just flowing in the time of 600 seconds. 600 seconds. Now I have to calculate how much charge has moved in that conductor. That also we will calculate. We already know that what is the formula says, current I is equal to Q divided by T. We already know the formula. Now what exactly we have to calculate? We have to calculate the charge. Charge is nothing but Q. When T goes to other side, we will get the formula as I into T. What is I value written here? 0.5 ampere. How much time that current starts moving that charges? For 600 seconds into 600. So we will get the answer as 300 ohms. Now I am going to explain about electrical potential. We have already seen what is a 1 coulomb or 1 charge. We have already seen about what is 1 ampere. So how much time it is just flowing. All this we have done. Next important thing in electric current is electrical potential. So what is meant by electrical potential? See, one appliances needs about different quantity of charges. It may require differently also. How the human beings eating capacity, is it all same for everyone? No, different. Some will eat so much. Someone will eat very less only. Like that, appliances also will consume less current. Some will consume more current also, based on that electrical potential is coming over here. So what is meant by electrical potential? Electrical potentials are nothing but the amount, quantity of the charges is moving from one point to another for doing that work done. So for doing that work done, how much that quantity of charges are moving from one end to another end, that is what we call it as electrical potential. It should have that potential for doing that work. That is what we call it as electrical potential. Electrical potential unit we call it as volts. Okay. Now V. So what is its formula? It has to do W, work done. So that let us assume Q coulombs of charges are moving for doing the work done for W. So then we call this as 1 volt. When 1 coulomb of charge is moving for doing 1 joule of work, then we call this as 1 volt. Next, let us see also about potential difference. So what is meant by potential difference? Potential difference is nothing but where that source is there we will have electrical potential more. Where the appliance started working there, it has to do certain work, so it will consume only some part of it only. So how the mother is cooking that vessels, that entire vessels, but is it that entire vessel food she supplying for one child only? No. So how much that one child needed, accordingly she will supply. Here also like that, some difference will be there. Then only the current will start to flow. If there is no difference is there, electric potential never starts to move at all. So where that source is there we already know at home 240 voltages will be there. So where that bulbs are, we are just running that, so it may require about some 15-20 volts something only. Okay, now how to, that is what we call this as potential difference. Now you understood. Now I am just going to show one of the calculation part. Going to explain about one of the few sums here. Let us say 2 voltage of current is moving. Now the charged particles are moving about 2 coulombs of charges. Now what is 2 coulombs? 2 coulombs are nothing but 2 into 6 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons. So how much will get? 12 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons will start to move for running that 2 voltage some appliances. Now we have to calculate what is the work done. We already know the formula V equal to W divided by Q. Now we have to calculate what is the work done. So what we will get work done? Work done equal to when Q goes to other side, we will get V into Q. So what is the V value I written here? 2. So 2 into 2. So how much you will get? Totally 4 joules. So amount of work done for running the 2 voltage appliances, it has done the work about 4 joules.